Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. We'll start with Midjourney and their new web editor, which is pretty cool. They've released this new unified interface which can do everything and more that you used to have to do with multiple steps. Let me show you how I'll make the thumbnail to today's video. So usually I type in a prompt such as powerful wizard in the matrix, unsure what is real, reaching a hand out to the camera, high detail. I also like to click here from previous times. I've got a photo of me there so it can get a character reference. Also, I put a character weight of around 30, so it gives me wizard-like clothes. I do it in the AR16:9 format, that's aspect ratio for a YouTube thumbnail, and of course the latest Midjourney version 6.1. Let's generate something with that prompt. AI and hands. I don't know what it is with hands and AI. Anyway, this one probably looks the most realistic, so let's go with this one. And now you'll see in the bottom right over here, I've got the ability to go into the editor, and this is where I can have some fun if I like. So if I want to, I can select this whole hand like so and turn it into something else. So I've selected the hand and I've just changed the prompt to say reaching a cucumber out to the camera. Let's generate again and see what comes up. And okay. Yeah, there's a weird, strange, awful hand there. This one is fairly realistic. But maybe we'll leave that one out. So that's an example of inpainting with the editor. But going back to this original image, I can now just undo that. And if I like, I can go ahead and grab this handle and maybe move my wizard over this side. And now you'll notice I've got a little bit extra there. So that's okay. I can also change the aspect ratio if I'd like, which is really cool. And I can even grab these handles to resize if I want to sort of resize the image. So let's go with that and see what other generations we get from this. I might actually just move that over so we just get that little lighting out from the corner over there. It's a bit. And we're still very much working with cucumbers, which I forgot about. So let's change that. Now I've just moved this over here. Now I can actually change the size of my brush, make it a bit smaller. I'm just going to paint this out because it's a little bit of a distraction from the main image. And let's delete the word cucumber and just leave it as is. Okay, I feel pretty good about this one, so I'm going to go ahead and download the image, bring it into Adobe Express, make the thumbnail for this video, and I've used the new Midjourney Web Editor to make the changes easy. Okay, next up is Grok 2. It was released this week on the X platform, Elon Musk's great social network, and it can do some pretty insane stuff. I'm going to give you two use cases now, including image generation that is pretty much completely uncensored now, which is insane. It's teaming up with Black Forest Labs' Flux AI image generator, which is really cool, and I did speak about it in a video not so long ago, so I'll link to that on the screen and down below if you want to go and learn more about Flux. It's the image generator working under the hood with Grok, but now I'll just type in a prompt, and yes, you can ask for an image of Donald Trump, and it will do that. Yeah, you got it. Donald Trump can be a brand ambassador for creator magic. Now, I'll do this one in real time so you get an idea how quick it is. An image of Albert Einstein holding a glowing orb of energy with the words creator magic illuminating the scene. And by the time I've finished telling you that, here is Albert Einstein on the screen. See, it is fast and it is good. Let's do Mickey Mouse. Loving that. That's so, so cool. Bart Simpson. Eat my shorts. Oprah Winfrey. Yeah, loving that. That's cool. Michael Jackson. No issue for Grok there. Beyonce. Nice. And let's get some Steve Jobs going on as well. Okay, that's epic. But that's not all. Another great use case for Grok is that it can pull real-time information on different people. So if you're meeting someone or you've just met someone and you want to know more about them, you can ask Grok. Let's try it out. So I've asked, tell me what you can find out about Mike Russell from Creator Magic. Okay, this is really interesting. So it's picked up on my audio production background and podcasting as well, which is really good. 25 years of experience, professional background, working with voiceover artists. It knows a lot about me just by prompting it with my name and the name of my YouTube channel. Talks all about Creator Magic, where I talk about AI tools and news. This channel is not that old and it's got that information, which is cool. Social media presence. Mike Russell maintains an active presence on Instagram. No, I do not. That's not correct. So you can't trust everything you read, of course. Recent activities and plans. I've expressed my ongoing excitement for creation. Okay, yes, and some unconventional projects in the pipeline. Interesting. Public sentiment. There's a sense of respect and admiration from his peers and followers. So that's really nice of Grok to say that. And of course, it goes on to talk about my recent AI tool coverage like MoshiChat, Runway Gen 3 and 11 Labs Speech, which is absolutely the tools I've been talking about. So yeah, 90% of that, 95% of that is accurate. Just the Instagram thing wasn't quite bang on, but it's a good way to get a broader overview of someone you've just met or someone you're about to meet. Let's ask this follow-up question, which is really good if you're about to meet someone. I have an AI app that clips videos into short shareable clips. How could I collab with him? And again, yeah, much of the stuff coming out here is fairly generic, but it does say content creation workshops and webinars, integrations or feature highlight in his content, product development, interviews and podcasts. So yeah, very generic kind of suggestions there, but it might give you an idea on how you can cross promote or work with someone before you meet them. So a great new tool, Grok 2. It's available to premium and premium plus subscribers of X. And this is actually pretty cool. I look forward to seeing what Elon Musk has up his sleeve next. And finally, I wanted to show you a tool that I've been using for a while, actually. It's called the Gigabrain, and it curates the whole of Reddit and spoken word human conversations to find the answer to your question. Now, you might say, well, how does that differ from SearchGPT or Perplexity, for instance, which I'm also a big fan of? And the Gigabrain specifically focuses on Reddit and conversational threads rather than just scanning the whole internet. It's looking for discussion. So if you want to find the best of something, if you're about to buy something, it might be good to get recommendations here rather than scour across the web. So let me give you an example of how this works. Like I said, I've been using it for a while, but it's trending this week because it ranked high on Product Hunt, and I just think it's cool, so I wanted to show you. So for instance, best microphone for YouTube. This is something I know a bit about, so I can tell you how good the answer is. Let's hit enter. Now it will ask you to create an account. You can do so with Google if you like. And now here we go. It's searching across all the Reddit threads there, YouTubers, YouTubers, live sound, and in real time, it is actually giving that update that it's found from Reddit, and it'll reference all of the source threads as well down here, so you know you're getting a good curated kind of search across Reddit that would take you traditionally ages to look through every single thread and make up your own mind. So it said to me here, the Blue Snowball and for fine USB mic, the Samsung Q2U, the Rode Video Mic Go or Pro Plus. do you know what? If I'm to be absolutely honest, I wouldn't recommend any of those microphones myself. As an audio expert with another channel where I talk about audio production, I'd probably say something like a condenser microphone such as Audio Technica, Neumann is always good, or a shotgun microphone from Rode, not one of the pros, because those generally would go on top of your camera or something like that. But anyway, it's a good way to get an idea on what it is you might want to buy or work on next. The Gigabrain is really cool, and of course, I'll link it down below. Finally, I'd like to finish this video by talking about Lily Ashwood. Is she real or is she a bot? Maybe an advanced AI, maybe signs and sparks of AGI, or a new model from OpenAI such as GPT-5. It's caused a bit of a stir in X spaces recently. I Rule the World MO has been talking about this. We've also heard from Chris Universe, who's hosted the spaces, and this Lily Ashwood profile popped up just a few days ago on X, which is pretty suspicious. Anyway, I have my thoughts on it, and I've created a new video that I'd like you to go and watch next to find out my deep audio analysis on Lily Ashwood as to whether this is really a new advanced AI model or just a human having a laugh. Watch that next. Well, go on then. Thanks.